Now, as we come to the 24th chapter of Job, friends, we see Job's answer that he's giving here to Eliphaz, and he is already in the 23rd chapter, expressed a desire to find God, because the invitation that Eliphaz gave him was, acquaint now thyself with him. Now, Job knows him as Redeemer. He calls him that. But he doesn't understand what's happening to him. And he needs the comfort and the help and the light from heaven. And that hasn't been forthcoming from his friends. Now, Eliphaz also did something else that was quite terrible, I think. He picked up the gossip, because this old natural heart of man, they conceive all kinds of things when they don't know the facts. And they knew Job was suffering, and that apparently God was punishing him, and it was some secret sin. And that was pretty much the understanding. Now, Eliphaz makes a stab at the trouble of Job, and he begins to try to ferret out the thing, that secret sin that he thinks is in his life. And so we find now Job turns to that, by the way, before he finishes answering him, and it causes him actually to become more defensive. In fact, it raises another question with him. And the question is this: why is God so exacting with me? And he apparently condones the actions of others that are really sinners, and it's out in the open that they are sinners. And so he begins to deal with that in the 24th chapter. Listen to him. He says, why, seeing times are not hidden from the Almighty, do they that know him not see his days? Some remove the landmarks. Now, they're dishonest. They remove landmarks. They violently take away flocks. They steal and feed thereof. They drive away the ass of the fatherless. They take the widow's ox for a pledge. They're dishonest in their dealings, and they take advantage of others, of their need. They turn the needy out of the way. The poor of the earth hide themselves together. And he says, they reap every one his corn in the field, and they gather the vintage of the wicked. Why, he says, the corn crop of the wicked makes as many bushels to the acre as it does of the righteous. And Job says, why does that happen? He says, they've committed murder, they've robbed, they've committed adultery, yet this whole evil brood, they actually are permitted to go down to the grave just like others. That's what he's saying in this chapter. And it's just like snow that's melted by the drought and the heat. They just disappear like the others. And that's not all, he says. Not only are they immune from justice in this life, he says they're actually favored. Because look at his condition. And poor Job is sick in this condition. He looks over at the wicked, and he's getting along nicely. And he says, I just don't understand this. Now, this is the whole thought that we have here in chapter 24. And in other words, instead of helping Job, they've given him another cause for complaint and also of defending himself. He says, I want to know why I'm ferreted out and I'm treated like this. And I suppose that as a minister, when I was pastor, I've heard this. I'm almost willing to say 1,000 times. And you know what the question is? Always. Why does God let this happen to me? And that's what Job is saying here. Why is God letting this happen to me? And what is the premise? The premise is, well, I'm such a nice, fine fella. That crowd over there are wicked. Oh, my friends, today, that is a question that comes in the minds of many. You see, Job doesn't understand God, and we're going to find out he doesn't understand himself either. And yet he has a great faith in God with the limited knowledge that he has.